Good day, Luke here from QC3D. See a lot of folks doing their print farm updates on YouTube. I'm going to do my print garden. I'm currently running just 4 printers, but I've got a Prusa in the mail. Should be here any day now, and something else in the mail here, the tryout, but let me give you a quick tour. Just built this little shelf / cabinet. Kind of unexpectedly had to relocate my printers here to kind of the mechanical room. As you see, we got the HVAC from my office. Other crafty ideas will be going on in the office shortly. But hey, let's take a look here. So, got this shelf from Home Depot, a nice adjustable shelf kind of unit. Had 2 extra shelves, so I took the panels and put the panels on the side. And I just got 2 pieces of plexiglass from Home Depot and put some doors on here. But yeah, so this is the setup currently. Got some filament storage down below. I've been an Inland Microcenter PLA filament user for a while, and I've just recently tried some of this GST stuff. It's going all right. I mean, I still like that Inland a touch more, but kind of still in this decision phase here with that GST filament. But yeah, check out the cabinet here. One of my first printers, and actually first printer is right here. This was my first Ender 3 Pro, and I knew this thing inside and out. Just a couple initial prints I did, you know, the spool guide, the little camera holders for my Wyze cameras, a couple covers and stuff I did were my first prints on this. Actually, my first roll of filament was that neon green. Actually, still have a little left there, but yeah, not too many upgrades other than the plastics there. Actually, just, I mean, it's been a year since I had this, almost a year, and I just put on that metal extruder there, you know, the Capricorn tubes. Another thing that you really can't see from here, but in the back of the printers, I put that lead screw. I put, there's a I'll sneak you in here. That thing right there. So what I found is that that little lead screw holder up top or whatever, it keeps that thing from vibrating. I have multiple printers going. If one of them is doing like a, you know, kind of a quick motion, it could vibrate, and that cleaned up my prints a lot. So I've got that on a couple of the printers here. So that was my first printer. Second printer here, right, was actually this blue one. The second one, this was so did open box buy on this at Micro Center, $159, not a bad deal. It was practically new. Looks like somebody attempted to put it together and couldn't finish, so picked that up. Printer 3 is this one. Another Ender 3 Pro. Don't have the upgraded extruder on there yet, but I do have that little guide up top. I recently did, I was always magnetic beds. I had one glass bed and the rest were magnetic, and I did different things on different beds. But now I've just put glass beds on 3 of my 4 printers here. And I'm just using a brim. I've never used a brim really, and that kind of helps. Things stick on there a little better, so we're doing that. A little more cleanup on the parts, but, and they're nice. They're clean on the bottom, which these magnetic beds here, I mean, they give you kind of a rough finish on the parts. So, yeah, right now, yeah. So, no secrets here. These are actually clips that I designed quickly for my Christmas lights to hold my Christmas lights to a fence around my backyard. So. Yeah, we can show you what we're making. These are just blasting these off. I'm going to need a bunch to go around my fence. This one here is doing some parts for a little product I just designed that I made for myself, and it ends up a lot of people want that, so we're mass producing them, and we'll see that in just a minute here in the packaging shipping area. So yeah, I don't know what else to say about all the cameras are on the Wyze camera, so easy to pull up one touch in the Wyze app. I can pull up all four cameras to see how things are going. I'll show you a little more on this cabinet here in just a minute to do some other neat things with it. Yeah, very excited about this cabinet here. I just made this these doors yesterday, and I have a little temp and humidity sensor in here, a little Wi-Fi sensor, a Govi unit there, and for the first time that thing is actually the heat exceeded a level that I set, and the humidity dropped down extensively with those doors on it last night. So I was very excited about that we're keeping some good temperature in there. Sheet of drywall in the back of the unit here also keeps some heat in and protect the open insulation and wood framing behind. So that's the current print garden, and not a print farm really as of yet. I do Etsy, Facebook sales, and also some custom items that I do, and this is I do this part-time, so I travel for my day job, typically Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday during the week. So this is kind of get home Friday, fire these up, print all throughout the weekend. They put inventory together, and then have everything ready to go so the wife can ship it out during the week while I'm gone. So that's the printers. That's the little cabinet I made. Let's spin around here. Oh, there's orders getting ready to go out. So this is kind of my, there's my photo booth. Supply, some pre-packaged items, some new items, things drying with glue, boxes, mailers, things that I, supplies. There, got my Rollo printer. That thing, another milestone. I just went through a stack of 500 of those labels, just reloaded another one. Some tape, some supplies, those little bins back there house some of the items I sell, and then also screws and parts for the printers. Glues, a couple items. The KISS Gene Simmons light switch I just made. This was a fun little project. Some parts here just waiting to be assembled. Some magnetic rolls that for certain parts that need magnetic strips. So another camera. This camera's job here is just I can pan tilt this around. Hey, what did I leave something on the table, or look over and make sure a label printed, because I do a lot of my label printing remotely. Glues. Here's some of those brackets for my fence. This is really cool. So let me show you this. This is a stream deck. What I do with this is you can come here. Let's hit stamps.com, and boom, we're opening stamps.com. So it's a great shortcut to open up all the programs that need opened up. Etsy, Facebook, where I sell. Pull those open. It can print the labels from there. But also I can control lighting. So my printer lights. Hit that. And boom, off go the lights. Turn that back on. So controls all my lights, and I don't want to do it right now, but my printers, I can turn on and off, open up Fusion 360. Cool little unit there. Still got a couple buttons I can fill in. That's a quick tour. Workspace, do a lot of the design myself. Most of it, all of it, yeah. Occasionally, if I print something else from Thingiverse, it's a tool that I need. A lot of these pre-made, spool brackets and items for the printers, I'll get those online. But everything else I make myself, and all the items I sell. So, hey, thanks for checking out my 3D print garden. I'll catch you later.